Hi friends, today let's solve 2018 Telangana ESET questions on communication systems. So this is your first question. So the image channel sensitivity of a super heterodyne receiver will generally depend upon preselector and RF amplifier, because preselector will be selecting the range of frequencies. You can imagine 88 to 108 megahertz for FM, and RF amplifier is tuned to amplify only particular selected frequencies, for example 102.7 megahertz. So image channel selectivity of a super heterodyne will be depending upon only on preselector and RF amplifier. So here you have an equation. He is asking what exactly this equation will represent. So remember, the equation of narrow band FM will be of this nature: AC into cos 2 pi FCT minus beta times AC into sin 2 pi FCT into sin 2 pi FMT. So observe the components, and if you see the answer, it is similar to a narrow band FM signal. So the input to a coherent detector is a DSBSC signal plus noise. Now the noise at the detector output is coherent in nature. So remember, if you have a DSBSC signal given to a product modulator with local oscillator where you have your carrier signal, and if you pass the signal over a low pass filter, you will be getting your demodulated output. This is the block diagram. So if you observe, so here same carrier signal which is used for generating the DSBSC signal is used, and that is why you call it coherent or synchronous detection. So both of them are in phase components. Okay, so in this process the message signal can be extracted from DSBSC only when you multiply with the carrier having same frequency. Okay, so the next question: the signal to quantization ratio in an n-bit PCM, I think we have discussed already earlier, it is 6.02 n decibels plus 1.76. okay, this is the formula, and see it, as the value of n increases, here n is simply the number of bits per sample. So if you remember your formula 6n, as n increases, your signal to quantization noise will be increasing. Next, in delta modulation, the slope over distortion can be reduced. So this error, slope over load distortion, to reduce this, you have to have your step size increased. Okay, so this is the option. I'll show you the diagram why you have to increase your step size. So see this. So slope overload error distortion, this is, see this particular slope. So to reduce this error, if you increase the number of steps, automatically it must be increased when the slope of the signal is high. Okay, next, in binary data transmission, DPSK is preferred to PSK because coherent carrier is not required to be generated at the receiver. So let's see the block diagram of your DPSK modulator. So see this, a DPSK modulator will need a delay unit and a balanced modulator and an LPF to generate your signal. There is no need of local oscillator in a DPSK demodulator. That is the question asked. So try to remember the block diagram. So TDMA allows the users to have, this is the definition of TDMA, it is using, you will be having the same frequency channel but different time slots will be given in case of a TDMA. So which device converts a guided electromagnetic wave on a transmission line into a plane wave propagating into space? So generally, antenna, transmitting antenna is a device that converts a guided electromagnetic wave on a transmission line into a plane wave propagating into a free space. So see the options. Only the transmitting antenna will be doing the conversion. So remember, the transmitters radiate energy into free space and the receivers receive the signal from free space. So which of the antenna is used in TV transmission? Generally, turnstile antennas are used for TV transition. So I will show you how exactly a turnstile antenna will look for better understanding. So see this. So antenna, turnstile antenna is used in axial mode, in which the antenna radiates circularly polarized radiation, and in the spectral specialized normal mode, turnstile antennas are used in television broadcasting antennas. So this is how it looks, turnstile antenna. So the modes of propagation supported by a rectangular waveguide. So generally, rectangular waveguide will support both TE and TM modes, but it will not support TEM mode. So observe the options. So whenever you have TEM mode, it is not supported by rectangular waveguide. So in waveguide, you have only single conductor which is present. So whenever you have one single conductor, it will not, does not support TEM propagation. Okay. So standard question, helical antenna is used in satellite tracking for circular polarization. So what exactly is a circular helical antenna? A helical antenna is a special antenna which emits and responds to electromagnetic fields rotating in circular polarization. So the antenna elements are commonly used at earth-based stations in satellite communication, and this type of antenna is designed for use in unbalanced feed line such as in coaxial cables. Remember this. Next. So mobile switching center would process the call made by one mobile phone user to another mobile phone. Public switching telephone network would be involved in processing a call when the call is made in mobile phone user. Both the MSC and PSTN networks process a call made for mobile landline. Electronic serial number is a telephone number in cell phone instruments. So you have four statements in this case. MSC, mobile switching center, is connected to a closed telephone exchange by a trunk group. So this provides an interface to PSTN network, and it also provides connectivity to this PSTN network. So also remember, PSTN is a public switch telephone network, and if you observe here, they will not process the call. So I'll show you the diagram of how this will look for better understanding. So this is your helical antenna, how it will look and how it radiates. So see this, PSTN networks will have MSCs and your base stations. Remember this, what exactly? So PSTN works using underground copper cables that are hardwired, okay? So in cellular network, simultaneous users over the channel is achieved by CDMA and TDMA. So here you have the concept of frequency reuse also. So what exactly is frequency reuse? So frequency reuse is a concept of using the same radio frequencies in a given area that are separated by considerable distance with less or minimal interference, so as to you can establish the communication. So if you have n cells using the same number of frequencies and k to be the total number of frequencies used in systems. So CDMA and TDMA are digital cellular technology which use spread spectrum technique. Remember this, they also deliver wireless services. So these are not used in cellular networks, only these two are used in cellular networks. Next, on a surface queuing handover request seems to be a bad scheme, not possible since handover must be noticed, but it in turns out that queuing handover request is possible. Now what exactly is this handover request? Remember, handover procedures are a key for function of LTE, long term evolution ENBs, and these are intended to reduce the interruption time. So the interruption time are supposed to be reduced in circuit switched handover process in 2G. So handover basically is used in EUTRAN. Okay, so this is an advanced question. So here the answer is this particular thing. There exists a time interval between the mobile phone reaching the handover and threshold. So with this, the questions related to communications are completed here.